New Jersey CDL air brakes test.
Question 1. Your bus or truck has a dual air brake system. If a low air pressure warning comes on for only one system, what should you do?
Reduce your speed and drive to the nearest garage for repairs. Stop and safely park. Continue only after the system is fixed. Reduce your speed and test the remaining system while driving.
Answer.
Stop and safely park. Continue only after the system is fixed.
Question 2. To make an emergency stop with air brakes, using the stab braking method, you should
brake hard until the wheels lock, and then get off the brakes for as much time as the wheels were locked. Press on the brake pedal as hard as you can, release the brakes when the wheels locked, put on the brakes again when the wheels start rolling. Pump the brake pedal rapidly and lightly.
Answer.
Press on the brake pedal as hard as you can. Release the brakes when the wheels locked, put on the brakes again when the wheels start rolling.
Question 3. The most common type of foundation brake found on heavy vehicles is the
wedge drum, disc drum, S-cam drum.
Answer.
S-cam drum.
Question 4. If you must make an emergency stop, brakes so you
can steer and your vehicle stays in a straight line, use the full power of the brakes to lock them. Use the handbrake before the brake pedal.
Answer.
Can steer and your vehicle stays in a straight line.
Question 5. Excessive use of the service brakes results in overheating, which can lead to
increase contact between the brake drums and linings, expansion of the brake drums, proper adjustment of S-cam.
Answer.
Expansion of the brake drums.
Question 6. Which of these is not a proper time to apply the parking brakes?
If you are going to use the parking brakes, you need to make sure that they will hold the vehicle. To use parking brakes if you park for less than 1 hour. If your brakes are very hot.
Answer.
If your brakes are very hot.
Question 7. If your truck has a properly functioning dual air brake system and minimum size air tanks, the air pressure should build from 85 to 100 pounds per square inch within seconds.
20. 45. 60.
Answer.
45.
Question 8. To test the air service brakes, you should
brake firmly while slowly moving forward. Brake firmly while slowly moving backwards. Stop the vehicle, put it in low gear. Depress the service brake, and then gently pull against the brakes.
Answer.
Brake firmly while slowly moving forward.
Question 9. To test the air leakage rate, you should
charge the air system and leave the engine running. leave the engine running and release the parking brake. Turn off the engine and release the parking brake.
Answer.
Turn off the engine and release the parking brake.
Question 10. If your truck has a properly functioning dual air brake system and minimum size air tanks, the air pressure should build from 85 to 100 pounds per square inch within seconds.
45. 20. 60.
Answer.
45.
Question 11. If air pressure is not built up fast enough within the correct amount of time,
you should be ready to use your parking brakes to stop. The alcohol container may be low. Your air pressure may drop too low during driving.
Answer.
Your air pressure may drop too low during driving.
Question 12. You should know that your brakes are fading when
the brake feels spongy when pressure is applied. You have to press the brake pedal harder to control speed on a downgrade. Pressure on the brake pedal is released and speed increases.
Answer.
You have to press the brake pedal harder to control speed on a downgrade.
Question 13. The brake chamber fills with air pushing the rod out, which moves the, which twists the
slack adjuster and brake camshaft. Brake camshaft and tie rod. Slack adjuster and tie rod.
Answer.
Slack adjuster and brake camshaft.
Question 14. Excessive heat in the brakes can cause the
brakes to fade or fail. Brake lines to plug. Modulating control valve to wear out.
Answer.
Brakes to fade or fail.
Question 15. Your truck has a dual air system and one of the system loses its pressure. What will happen?
Either the front or back brake will not be fully operational. The manual slack adjusters of the S-cam brakes will not be set properly. Brake drums will not be fully pressurized.
Answer.
Either the front or back brake will not be fully operational.
Question 16. The air compressor stops pumping air at what size?
150. 100. 125.
Answer.
125.
Question 17. When you put the brakes on by pushing down on the brake pedal,
air pressure is applied to the brake pads. Compressed air is let go out of the system. The air pressure is reduced to the brake pads.
Answer.
Air pressure is applied to the brake pads.
Question 18. Total stopping distance for air brakes is longer than that for hydraulic brakes due to distance.
Effective braking. Brake lag. Reaction distance.
Answer.
brake lag.
Question 19. What is another name for controlled braking?
Steady braking. Hard braking. Squeeze braking.
Answer.
Squeeze braking.
Question 20. What are the slack adjusters?
It is an adjusting nut under the cab to adjust the springs. It is an adjusting nut on that the back side of the brake drum used for adjusting the brakes. It is the space between the back wheels.
Answer.
It is an adjusting nut on that the back side of the brake drum used for adjusting the brakes.
Question 21. Excessive heat in the brakes can cause the
modulating control valve to wear out. Brake lines to plug. Brakes to fade or fail.
Answer.
Brakes to fade or fail.
Question 22. The brake chamber fills with air pushing the rod out which twists the
brake camshaft and tie rod. Slack adjuster and brake camshaft. Slack adjuster and tie rod.
Answer.
Slack adjuster and brake camshaft.
Question 23. Converter dollies built on or after March 1, 1998 are required to have anti-lock brakes. These dollies will have
a yellow malfunction lamp on the left side of the dolly. A yellow malfunction lamp on the right side of the dolly. A yellow malfunction lamp in the center of the dolly.
Answer.
A yellow malfunction lamp on the left side of the dolly.
Question 24. The spring brakes used on the chambers in a straight truck will bring you to a stop when air pressure drops below. Psi.
60. 100. 20.
Answer.
20.
Question 25. The air compressor stops pumping air at what psi?
150. 100. 125.
Answer.
125.
Question 26. If the spring brakes are on, when should you push the brake pedal?
Only when driving downhill. Never. Only on the slippery road.
Answer.
Never.
Question 27. The application pressure gauge shows how much pressure you have.
In a modulating control valve. In the tanks. When you are applying to the brakes.
Answer.
When you are applying to the brakes.
Question 28. Air brake equipped vehicles have
an air use gauge. An air supply pressure gauge. A backup hydraulic system.
Answer.
An air supply pressure gauge.
Question 29. Excessive heat in the brakes can cause the
brakes to fade or fail. Brake lines to plug. Modulating control valve to wear out.
Answer.
Brakes to fade or fail.
Question 30. Why must air tanks be drained?
To drain all the air out of the tank. To drain moisture and oil out of tank. To tell you how much air is in the air tanks.
Answer.
To drain moisture and oil out of tank.
Question 31. For air brake systems in good condition, the air compressor should start pumping at about psi
100, 125, 150.
Answer.
100.
Question 32. With air brake vehicles, the parking brakes should be used
as little as possible. Whenever you leave the vehicle unattended. Only during pre-trip and post-trip inspections.
Answer.
Whenever you leave the vehicle unattended.
Question 33. If your bus or truck has dual parking control valves, you can use pressure from a separate tank to
release the spring emergency parking brakes to move a short distance. Stay parked twice as long without using up service air pressure. Balance the service brake system when you are parked.
Answer.
Release the spring emergency parking brakes to move a short distance.
Question 34. If your vehicle has an alcohol evaporator, every day during cold weather you should
change the alcohol from a new bottle. Check and fill the alcohol level. Check the oil for alcohol content.
Answer.
Check and fill the alcohol level.
Question 35. Which of these is the most important thing to remember about emergency braking?
Never do it without downshifting first. If the wheels are skidding, you cannot control the vehicle. Disconnecting the steering axle brakes will help keep your vehicle in a straight line during emergency braking.
Answer.
If the wheels are skidding, you cannot control the vehicle.
Question 36. The braking power of the spring brakes
increases when the service brakes are hot. Is not affected by the condition of the service brakes. Depends on the service brakes being in adjustment.
Answer.
Depends on the service brakes being in adjustment.
Question 37. What is a dual air brake system?
A two braking system, one for daytime and one for nighttime driving. A two brake system, one operates the front brakes and one operates the back brakes. A two braking system, one for each side of the vehicle.
Answer.
A two brake system, one operates the front brakes and one operates the back brakes.
Question 38. Your truck has a dual air system and one of the system loses its pressure. What will happen?
Brake drums will not be fully pressurized. The manual slack adjusters of the S-cam brakes will not be set properly. Either the front or back brake will not be fully operational.
Answer.
Either the front or back brake will not be fully operational.
Question 39. Which of these is the most important thing to remember about emergency braking?
Never do it without downshifting first. If the wheels are skidding, you cannot control the vehicle. Disconnecting the steering axle brakes will help keep your vehicle in a straight line during emergency braking.
Answer.
If the wheels are skidding, you cannot control the vehicle.
Question 40. Controlled braking
involves locking the wheels for short periods of time. Is used to keep a vehicle in a straight line when braking. Can be used while you are turning sharply.
Answer.
Is used to keep a vehicle in a straight line when braking.
Question 41. Total stopping distance for air brakes is longer than that for hydraulic brakes due to distance.
Brake lag. Effective braking. Reaction distance.
Answer.
Brake lag.
Question 42. You are on a steep downgrade and have reached your safe speed of 40 miles per hour. You would apply the service brakes until your speed drops to miles per hour.
30. 25. 35.
Answer.
35.
Question 43. The stoplight switch
tells you when you need to use your emergency brakes. Turns on the brake lights to warn drivers behind you. Tells you when the air brake system is low on air pressure.
Answer.
Turns on the brake lights to warn drivers behind you.
Question 44. Which is the first thing you should do when a low air pressure warning comes on?
Upshift. Stop and safely park as soon as possible. Downshift.
Answer.
Stop and safely park as soon as possible.
Question 45. Modern air brake systems are three different systems combined together. They are the service, parking, and the brakes.
S-cam. Emergency. Foot.
Answer.
Emergency.
Question 46. If the air compressor should develop a leak, what keeps the air in the tanks?
The tractor protection valve. The emergency relay valve. The one-way check valve.
Answer.
The one-way check valve.
Question 47. Before driving a truck or bus with the dual air brake system, the pressure in each air brake system should be at least Sai.
80. 120. 100.
Answer.
100.
Question 48. How can you test the low pressure warning signal?
Shut off the engine with enough air pressure, turn on the electrical power and step on and off the brake pedal until the low air pressure warning signal comes on. While the engine is running, step on and off the brake pedal. Shut off the engine and see if the air pressure leaks down.
Answer.
Shut off the engine with enough air pressure, turn on the electrical power and step on and off the brake pedal until the low air pressure warning signal comes on.
Question 49. An air brake system is fully charged at what psi?
125. 150. 75.
Answer.
125.
Question 50. Why should you be in the proper gear before starting down a hill?
So you only have to apply the brake just hard enough to feel a definite slowdown. So you can go through the gears on the way down. So you can coast downhill.
Answer.
So you only have to apply the brake just hard enough to feel a definite slowdown.
Question 51. To test the air service brakes, you should
brake firmly while slowly moving forward. Brake firmly while slowly moving backwards. Stop the vehicle, put it in low gear, depress the service brake, and then gently pull against the brakes.
Answer.
Brake firmly while slowly moving forward.
Question 52. Air brake equipped vehicles have
an air supply pressure gauge, an air use gauge, a backup hydraulic system.
Answer.
An air supply pressure gauge.
Question 53. Which of these is not a proper time to apply the parking brakes?
To use parking brakes if you park for less than 1 hour. If your brakes are very hot. If you are going to use the parking brakes, you need to make sure that they will hold the vehicle.
Answer.
If your brakes are very hot.
Question 54. If the air compressor should develop a leak, what keeps the air in the tanks?
The one-way check valve. The tractor protection valve. The emergency relay valve.
Answer.
The one-way check valve.
Question 55. The S-cam forces the brake shoes away from one another and presses them against the inside of the brake drum. It is called the S-cam because
it is shaped like the letter S. It is shaped like the letter N. It is shaped like the letter Z.
Answer.
It is shaped like the letter S.
Question 56. To correct a drive wheel braking skid, you should
increase braking, increase braking, turn quickly, and counter steer. Stop braking, turn quickly, and counter steer.
Answer.
Stop braking, turn quickly, and counter steer.
Question 57. How can you test the low pressure warning signal?
Shut off the engine and see if the air pressure leaks down. Shut off the engine with enough air pressure, turn on the electrical power and step on and off the brake pedal until the low air pressure warning signal comes on. While the engine is running, step on and off the brake pedal.
Answer.
Shut off the engine with enough air pressure, turn on the electrical power and step on and off the brake pedal until the low air pressure warning signal comes on.
Question 58. The parking brake applies and releases.
The brake pedal during normal driving. In the event of an emergency. The parking brakes when you use the parking brake control.
Answer.
The parking brakes when you use the parking brake control.
Question 59. If you do not have automatic tank drains, how often should you drain the oil and water from the bottom of compressed air storage tanks?
At the end of each day of driving. After every 4 hours of service. Once a week.
Answer.
At the end of each day of driving.
Question 60. Some air brake systems have an alcohol evaporator. What may happen if you don't keep the unit filled with alcohol?
Ice may form on the brake pads and warp them. The S-cam may not rotate back when you release the brake pedal. Ice may form in the air storage tanks and cause the brakes to fail.
Answer.
Ice may form in the air storage tanks and cause the brakes to fail.
Question 61. The parking or emergency brake on a heavy vehicle can only be held in position by something that cannot leak away, like
hydraulic pressure, spring pressure, air pressure.
Answer.
Spring pressure.
Question 62. The service brake applies and releases.
In the event of an emergency. The parking brake when you use the parking brake control. The brake when you use the brake pedal during normal driving.
Answer.
The brake when you use the brake pedal during normal driving.
Question 63. If you do not have automatic tank drains, how often should you drain the oil and water from the bottom of compressed air storage tanks?
After every 4 hours of service. Once a week. At the end of each day of driving.
Answer.
At the end of each day of driving.
Question 64. The air brake system for a straight truck or bus should not leak at a rate of more than psi per minute with the engine off and the brakes released.
3. 1. 2.
Answer.
2.
Question 65. What is another name for controlled braking?
Squeeze braking. Hard braking. Steady braking.
Answer.
Squeeze braking.
Question 66. The air compressor governor controls.
Air pressure applied to the brakes. The speed of the air compressor. When air is pumped into the air storage tanks.
Answer.
When air is pumped into the air storage tanks.
Question 67. What is the purpose of an alcohol evaporator?
To have a drink available if you get thirsty. To reduce the risk of ice in the brake valves and other parts in cold weather. So you don't have to drain the air tanks as often.
Answer.
To reduce the risk of ice in the brake valves and other parts in cold weather.
Question 68. Which is the first thing you should do when a low air pressure warning comes on?
Upshift. Downshift. Stop and safely park as soon as possible.
Answer.
Stop and safely park as soon as possible.
Question 69. Converter dollies built on or after March 1, 1998 are required to have anti-lock brakes. These dollies will have
a yellow malfunction lamp on the right side of the dolly. A yellow malfunction lamp in the center of the dolly. A yellow malfunction lamp on the left side of the dolly.
Answer.
A yellow malfunction lamp on the left side of the dolly.
Question 70. The air supply pressure gauge shows how much pressure
you have used in this trip is going to the brake chambers, is in the air tanks.
Answer.
Is in the air tanks.
Question 71. Air braking takes more time than hydraulic braking because air.
Air brakes use different brake drums. Takes more time to flow through the lines than hydraulic fluid. Brakes require heavier return springs.
Answer.
Takes more time to flow through the lines than hydraulic fluid.
Question 72. The brake system that applies and releases the brakes when the driver uses the brake pedal is the brake system.
Service. Emergency. Parking.
Answer.
Service.
Question 73. How can you test the low pressure warning signal?
While the engine is running, step on and off the brake pedal. Shut off the engine and see if the air pressure leaks down. Shut off the engine with enough air pressure, turn on the electrical power and step on and off the brake pedal until the low air pressure warning signal comes on.
Answer.
Shut off the engine with enough air pressure, turn on the electrical power and step on and off the brake pedal until the low air pressure warning signal comes on.
Question 74. The braking power of the spring brakes
increases when the service brakes are hot. Depends on the service brakes being in adjustment. Is not affected by the condition of the service brakes.
Answer.
Depends on the service brakes being in adjustment.
Question 75. The stoplight switch
turns on the brake lights to warn drivers behind you. Tells you when the air brake system is low on air pressure. Tells you when you need to use your emergency brakes.
Answer.
Turns on the brake lights to warn drivers behind you.
Question 76. What is the purpose of an alcohol evaporator?
To reduce the risk of ice in the brake valves and other parts in cold weather. So you don't have to drain the air tanks as often. To have a drink available if you get thirsty.
Answer.
To reduce the risk of ice in the brake valves and other parts in cold weather.
Question 77. Total stopping distance for air brakes is longer than that for hydraulic brakes due to distance.
Brake lag. Reaction distance. Effective braking.
Answer.
Brake lag.
Question 78. The air loss rate for a straight truck or bus with the engine off and the brakes on should not be more than
3 pounds per square inch in 1 minute. 1 pound per square inch in 1 minute. 2 pounds per square inch in 45 seconds.
Answer.
3 pounds per square inch in 1 minute.
Question 79. The brake chamber fills with air pushing the rod out which twists the
slack adjuster in brake camshaft. Brake camshaft and tie rod. Slack adjuster and tie rod.
Answer.
Slack adjuster in brake camshaft.
Question 80. The S-cam forces the brake shoes away from one another and presses them against the inside of the brake drum. It is called the S-cam because
it is shaped like the letter Z. It is shaped like the letter S. It is shaped like the letter N.
Answer.
It is shaped like the letter S.
Question 81. The S-cam
forces the brake shoes against the inside of the brake drum. Controls the flow air to each of the brake chambers. Pulls the brake shoes away from the drum and allow the wheels to roll freely.
Answer.
Forces the brake shoes against the inside of the brake drum.
Question 82. Under normal conditions, in order to engage the parking brakes, the driver must first
turn off the engine. Be sure air brakes system is fully pressurized. Let the air out of the spring brakes.
Answer.
Let the air out of the spring brakes.
Question 83. A slack adjuster's free play needs to be adjusted if it is more than how many inches when you pull hard on it?
1 inch. 1/4 inch. 1/2 inch.
Answer.
1 inch.
Question 84. The emergency brake system
uses parts of the service and parking brake system to stop the vehicle in the event of a brake system failure. Uses the service brake to stop the vehicle in the event of a brake system failure. Uses the parking brake to stop the vehicle in the event of a brake system failure.
Answer.
Uses parts of the service and parking brake system to stop the vehicle in the event of a brake system failure.
Question 85. Why drain water from the compressed air tanks?
Water can freeze in cold weather and cause brake failure. The low boiling point of water reduces braking power. To keep from fouling the air compressor oil.
Answer.
Water can freeze in cold weather and cause brake failure.
Question 86. The air compressor stops pumping air at what psi?
125. 150. 100.
Answer.
125.
Question 87. Converter dollies built on or after March 1, 1998 are required to have anti-lock brakes. These dollies will have
a yellow malfunction lamp in the center of the dolly. A yellow malfunction lamp on the left side of the dolly. A yellow malfunction lamp on the right side of the dolly.
Answer.
A yellow malfunction lamp on the left side of the dolly.
Question 88. If you do not have automatic tank drains, how often should you drain the oil and water from the bottom of compressed air storage tanks?
At the end of each day of driving. Once a week. After every 4 hours of service.
Answer.
At the end of each day of driving.
Question 89. Excessive heat in the brakes can cause the
modulating control valve to wear out. Brake lines to plug. Brakes to fade or fail.
Answer.
Brakes to fade or fail.
Question 90. The modulating control valve allows you to control the
spring brakes. Amount of pressure in the brake system. Front brakes.
Answer.
Spring brakes.
Question 91. It is accepted that too much heat caused by using your brakes too often can also cause
brake linings to split up, brake fade or failure, modulated control valve to wear out.
Answer.
Brake fade or failure.
Question 92. The service brake applies and releases.
In the event of an emergency, the parking brake when you use the parking brake control. The brake when you use the brake pedal during normal driving.
Answer.
The brake when you use the brake pedal during normal driving.
Question 93. The parking brake applies and releases.
The brake pedal during normal driving. In the event of an emergency. The parking brakes when you use the parking brake control.
Answer.
The parking brakes when you use the parking brake control.
Question 94. To check the brake slack adjusters on S-cam brakes you should park on.
Park on level ground and drain off air pressure before adjusting. Park on level ground, chock the wheels, and release the parking brakes. Stop on level ground and apply the parking brakes.
Answer.
Park on level ground, chock the wheels, and release the parking brakes.
Question 95. What is a dual air brake system?
A two brake system. One operates the front brakes and one operates the back brakes. A two braking system, one for daytime and one for nighttime driving. A two braking system, one for each side of the vehicle.
Answer.
A two brake system, one operates the front brakes and one operates the back brakes.
Question 96. The application pressure gauge shows how much pressure you have.
In a modulating control valve. When you are applying to the brakes. In the tanks.
Answer.
When you are applying to the brakes.
Question 97. The brake system that applies and releases the brakes when the driver uses the brake pedal is the brake system.
Parking. Emergency. Service.
Answer.
Service.
Question 98. You should know that your brakes are fading when
pressure on the brake pedal is released and speed increases. You have to press the brake pedal harder to control speed on a downgrade. The brake feels spongy when pressure is applied.
Answer.
You have to press the brake pedal harder to control speed on a downgrade.
Question 99. The emergency brake system
uses parts of the service and parking brake system to stop the vehicle in the event of a brake system failure. Uses the service brake to stop the vehicle in the event of a brake system failure. Uses the parking brake to stop the vehicle in the event of a brake system failure.
Answer.
Uses parts of the service and parking brake system to stop the vehicle in the event of a brake system failure.
Question 100. Before driving a truck or bus with a dual air brake system, the pressure in each air brake system should be at least psi
100, 80, 120.
Answer.
100.
Question 101. Total stopping distance for air brakes is longer than that for hydraulic brakes due to distance.
Reaction distance. Effective braking. Brake lag.
Answer.
Brake lag.
Question 102. Controlled braking
involves locking the wheels for short periods of time. Can be used while you are turning sharply. Is used to keep a vehicle in a straight line when braking.
Answer.
Is used to keep a vehicle in a straight line when braking.
Question 103. It is not safe to drive a vehicle that has brake drums, or discs, with cracks or that are thinner than the manufacturer's specifications. Generally this will be an inch,
one third, one half, one fourth.
Answer.
One half.
Question 104. Excessive use of the service brakes results in overheating, which can lead to
increased contact between the brake drums and linings. Proper adjustment of S-cam. Expansion of the brake drums.
Answer.
Expansion of the brake drums.
Question 105. The air loss rate for a straight truck or bus with the engine off and the brakes on should not be more than
2 pounds per square inch in 45 seconds. 1 pound per square inch in 1 minute. 3 pounds per square inch in 1 minute.
Answer.
3 pounds per square inch in 1 minute.
Question 106. The driver must be able to see a low pressure warning, which comes on before pressure in the service air tank falls below
100 pounds per square inch. 80 pounds per square inch. 60 pounds per square inch.
Answer.
60 pounds per square inch.
Question 107. The S-cam
controls the flow air to each of the brake chambers. Pulls the brake shoes away from the drum and allow the wheels to roll freely. Forces the brake shoes against the inside of the brake drum.
Answer.
Forces the brake shoes against the inside of the brake drum.
Question 108. The most common type of foundation brake found on heavy vehicles is the
disc drum, S-cam drum, wedge drum.
Answer.
S-cam drum.
Question 109. It is not safe to drive a vehicle that has brake drums, or discs, with cracks or that are thinner than the manufacturer's specifications. Generally this will be an inch,
one fourth, one third, one half.
Answer.
One half.
Question 110. Your bus or truck has a dual air brake system. If a low air pressure warning comes on for only one system, what should you do?
stop and safely park. Continue only after the system is fixed. Reduce your speed and drive to the nearest garage for repairs. Reduce your speed and test the remaining system while driving.
Answer.
Stop and safely park. Continue only after the system is fixed.
Question 111. Some air brake systems have an alcohol evaporator. What may happen if you don't keep the unit filled with alcohol?
Ice may form on the brake pads and warp them. Ice may form in the air storage tanks and cause the brakes to fail. The S-cam may not rotate back when you release the brake pedal.
Answer.
Ice may form in the air storage tanks and cause the brakes to fail.
Question 112. Which is the first thing you should do when a low air pressure warning comes on?
Stop and safely park as soon as possible. Downshift. Upshift.
Answer.
Stop and safely park as soon as possible.
Question 113. The use of air brakes on a down grid is only a supplement to the
use of the front brake limiting valve. Braking effect of the engine. Use of the spring brakes.
Answer.
Braking effect of the engine.
Question 114. How do you test the hydraulic brakes for leaks?
Pump the brake pedal 3 times, then apply firm pressure to the pedal and hold for 5 seconds. The pedal should not move. Drive slowly and pump the brake pedal. Make sure it doesn't hit the floor. Drive 20 miles per hour and slam on the brakes.
Answer.
Pump the brake pedal 3 times, then apply firm pressure to the pedal and hold for 5 seconds. The pedal should not move.
Question 115. When you put the brakes on by pushing down on the brake pedal,
the air pressure is reduced to the brake pads. Compressed air is let go out of the system. Air pressure is applied to the brake pads.
Answer.
Air pressure is applied to the brake pads.
Question 116. If air pressure is not built up fast enough within the correct amount of time,
your air pressure may drop too low during driving. The alcohol container may be low. You should be ready to use your parking brakes to stop.
Answer.
Your air pressure may drop too low during driving.
Question 117. The spring brakes used on the chambers in a straight truck will bring you to a stop when air pressure drops below. Psi.
20. 60. 100.
Answer.
20.
Question 118. Your truck has a dual air system and one of the system loses its pressure. What will happen?
The manual slack adjusters of the S-cam brakes will not be set properly. Brake drums will not be fully pressurized. Either the front or back brake will not be fully operational.
Answer.
Either the front or back brake will not be fully operational.
Question 119. What are spring brakes?
If the air brakes leak down, springs press the brakes on to stop the vehicle. The spring on the brake pedal. Brakes used for parking.
Answer.
If the air brakes leak down, springs press the brakes on to stop the vehicle.
Question 120. If your bus or truck has dual parking control valves, you can use pressure from a separate tank to
stay parked twice as long without using up service air pressure. Release the spring emergency parking brakes to move a short distance. Balance the service brake system when you are parked.
Answer.
Release the spring emergency parking brakes to move a short distance.
Question 121. It is not safe to drive a vehicle that has brake drums with cracks that are longer than of the width of the friction area.
1/4, 1/2, 5/16.
Answer.
1/2.
Question 122. The most important thing to do when a low air pressure warning comes on is
upshift, downshift, stop and safely park as soon as possible.
Answer.
Stop and safely park as soon as possible.
Question 123. The spring brakes used on the chambers in a straight truck will bring you to a stop when air pressure drops below. Psi.
60. 20. 100.
Answer.
20.
Question 124. The brake pedal in an air brake system.
Control the speed of the air compressor. Controls the air pressure applied to put on the brakes. Is connected to slack adjusters by a series of rods and linkages.
Answer.
Controls the air pressure applied to put on the brakes.
Question 125. Emergency control braking is when you
brake as hard as you can, release the brakes when the wheels lock, and put the brakes back on again when the wheels start rolling. Apply the hand valve for 1 second, then push hard on the brake pedal. Apply the brakes as hard as you can without locking the wheels.
Answer.
Apply the brakes as hard as you can without locking the wheels.
Question 126. With air brake vehicles, the parking brakes should be used
as little as possible. Only during pre-trip and post-trip inspections. Whenever you leave the vehicle unattended.
Answer.
Whenever you leave the vehicle unattended.
Question 127. How can you test the low pressure warning signal?
Shut off the engine with enough air pressure, turn on the electrical power and step on and off the brake pedal until the low air pressure warning signal comes on. While the engine is running, step on and off the brake pedal. Shut off the engine and see if the air pressure leaks down.
Answer.
Shut off the engine with enough air pressure, turn on the electrical power and step on and off the brake pedal until the low air pressure warning signal comes on.
Question 128. In air brake vehicles, the parking brake should be used
to hold your speed when going downhill. Anytime the vehicle is parked, as little as possible.
Answer.
Anytime the vehicle is parked.
Question 129. Your bus or truck has a dual air brake system. If a low air pressure warning comes on for only one system, what should you do?
Reduce your speed and test the remaining system while driving. Reduce your speed and drive to the nearest garage for repairs. Stop and safely park. Continue only after the system is fixed.
Answer.
Stop and safely park. Continue only after the system is fixed.
Question 130. The stoplight switch
tells you when you need to use your emergency brakes. Tells you when the air brake system is low on air pressure. Turns on the brake lights to warn drivers behind you.
Answer.
Turns on the brake lights to warn drivers behind you.
Question 131. Air brake equipped vehicles have
an air use gauge, an air supply pressure gauge, a backup hydraulic system.
Answer.
An air supply pressure gauge.
Question 132. Air braking takes more time than hydraulic braking because air
brakes require heavier return springs. Air brakes use different brake drums. Takes more time to flow through the lines than hydraulic fluid.
Answer.
Takes more time to flow through the lines than hydraulic fluid.
Question 133. The parking brake applies and releases
the brake pedal during normal driving. The parking brakes when you use the parking brake control. In the event of an emergency.
Answer.
The parking brakes when you use the parking brake control.
Question 134. What is the purpose of an alcohol evaporator?
To have a drink available if you get thirsty. To reduce the risk of ice in the brake valves and other parts in cold weather. So you don't have to drain the air tanks as often.
Answer.
To reduce the risk of ice in the brake valves and other parts in cold weather. Thank you for watching the video and wish you will get your driver license soon.